We want to solve the absolute value inequality. We want to express the solution as a compound inequality, a graph, and using interval notation. The first step in solving an absolute value inequality is to isolate the absolute value on one side of the inequality. So looking at our problem, we have 2 times the absolute value of x plus 2 minus 3 is greater than 5. We want to undo this subtraction and undo this multiplication. So just like an equation, we want to undo this subtraction first. So we'll add 3 to both sides of the inequality. So now we'll have 2 times the absolute value of x plus 2 is greater than 8, because this was 0. And now we'll undo this multiplication by dividing both sides by 2. Now we're dividing by a positive 2, so we do not reverse the inequality. So we'd have the absolute value of x plus 2 is greater than positive 4. And since absolute value means a number's distance from 0, we're now looking for the values of x so that x plus 2 would be more than 4 units from 0. And since our inequality symbol here is greater than, we'll now set up a compound inequality, or 2 inequalities, that will be connected by the word or. So for the first inequality, we'll just drop the absolute value. So we have x plus 2 is greater than 4. Or for the second inequality, we drop the absolute value, but then we also reverse the inequality symbol and change the sign of the 4. So we'll have less than negative 4. And now we'll solve these. So we'll subtract 2 on both sides. So we have x is greater than positive 2, or subtract 2 on both sides again. We have x is less than negative 6. So now we'll graph these 2 intervals, and then because it's an or, the union of these 2 intervals will be the solution to our absolute value inequality. So for x greater than 2, notice that 2 does not satisfy this inequality, and therefore is not in the interval, so we make an open point on 2, arrow to the right. And for x is less than negative 6, again, negative 6 is not in this interval, so we have an open point on negative 6, arrow to the left. And because we're looking for the union of these 2 intervals, both of these intervals would be the solution to the original absolute value inequality. And then using interval notation, to the right we're approaching positive infinity, and to the left we're approaching negative infinity. So for the interval on the left, we have negative infinity, comma, negative 6. It's open on negative 6, so we have a rounded parenthesis on the negative 6 as well as on the negative infinity. And then we could use the word or here, but a lot of times you'll see the symbol u for union, which means the same thing as or. And then for the interval from 2 to infinity, open on 2, we have a rounded parenthesis on 2 and a rounded parenthesis on infinity. So now we have the solution as a compound inequality here, as a graph, and expressed using interval notation. I hope you found this helpful.